Okay, this question is about magnesium and its compounds. State one observation when magnesium reacts with steam. So steam means that one's a gas, and if you remember, when magnesium, let's do the equation first, when magnesium reacts with water as steam, what we end up with is magnesium oxide instead of magnesium hydroxide, and that will be a solid with hydrogen gas given off. And of course, this is a solid as well. So it does say to include state symbols. If you're in the habit of that anyway, obviously you need to put them on. Observation, bright white light. But you could have white powder as an alternative for that one. Okay, next one, part B. Describe the bonding in magnesium. So on the periodic table, magnesium is metallic, so it is giant metallic. So always put the structure and bonding in, whether it's asked for or not. Sometimes it's needed, sometimes it isn't. And this is down to the strong electrostatic forces of attraction. You could just say strong attraction. And the moment you mention the word attraction, you've got to state what it is between. Okay, so this is between the positive magnesium ions and the negative delocalized electrons. So the marks for that is attraction between magnesium ions for one mark, and the second mark is for the delocalized electrons. Part C, explain in terms of structure and bonding. So obviously sometimes it's required, sometimes it isn't. This one it's stating that it is, why magnesium chloride has a higher melting point. So I'm going to start with the structure and bonding. So this is giant ionic. Okay, and again, strong electrostatic forces of attraction, but I'm just going to say attraction on this one. Between, in fact, I'm just going to put between oppositely charged ions. So there's one mark for each of those. Okay, so strong attraction between oppositely charged ions. Give one medical use for magnesium hydroxide. So indigestion tablets,